Is this true? Okay, we have this expression, and the answer is 16. Let's have a look. First thing first, what is the zero with an exclamation mark? I will tell you, this thing right here is called the factorial. And I wanted to say this right here because that's pretty much what it is for all this expression. I will put down a note real quick. If we have 0 factorial, this right here, the answer to that is equal to 1. And let me spell this out. This is called the factorial. And I'm going to explain this in detail later on. I will tell you guys why this is equal to 1. But let's just finish the computation. So this right here, this is just 1. And then we have to add another 1. And then raised to the power of 1 plus 1. And then we are going to multiply with this is 1 plus 1 and then raised to the power of 1 plus 1. And 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So this right here, we have 2 to the second power times this is 2 and then to the second power. 2 to the second power means 2 times 2, so we have 4. Times another 4. All in all, we get 16. So this is indeed correct. Now the question is, why is this 1 and what's the factorial thing? What if we don't have 0 factorial? How exactly do we do it? So here is the deal. When we have factorial, so just a quick lesson, and there are of course more details on this, but maybe in the future. When we have factorial business, let's say we have a number 4. If you have 4 factorial, just write it down like this. To compute it, you start with this number inside, which is 4, and you are going to multiply with the next number, which is 3, and you continue, which is the next number 2, and you multiply by with the last number, which is 1, and you stop right here. Do not multiply by 0 because otherwise everything is 0. So this means this kind of multiplication. And then just work that out, you end up with 24. Similarly, if you have 3 factorial, you will just start with 3 and you multiply by 2 and you multiply by 1 and the answer for that is just 6. And then 2 factorial is just 2 times 1, which is 2. And 1 factorial, you simply just put down 1. Okay, so it's just like this. And notice that this definition, this procedure only works when we have positive whole numbers. And in detail, I will write down, if you have some number n factorial, this right here means you have start with n, and you multiply by the next number, which is n minus 1, and then you multiply by the next number, which is n minus 2, and then so on, up to you just have 1, the last number you stop right here. But we have 0 though. If I put 0 in here, don't I just have 0? No, 0 is kind of like a special case. This definition only works when we have positive whole number. How about now? We look at the 0 factorial. Here's just a reason why we are going to do the following definition, and you'll see why 0 factorial should be equal to 1. Check this out. If you look at what I have right here, it's 4 factorial, and then 3 factorial, 2 factorial, and then 1 factorial, and then it's just 0 factorial at the end here, huh? Okay, so that's the pattern. I think we can all agree on that. On the right-hand side, if you look at the result, from 24 to 6, what do we do? Don't say subtract 18. It kind of works, but no, because that's not going to work out nicely if you go from 6 to 2. I'm going to look at from 24 to 6 as divided by 4. 24 divided by 4, we get 6. Well, it's not 6 divided by 4 to get 2. Instead, we have 6 divided by 3 to get 2. And then if you look at 2, we'll just divide it by 2. Notice the pattern is what? 4 divided by 2, 4 divided by 3 divided by 2. Following the same pattern, what do we do next though? Divided by 1. 1 divided by 1 is 1. There you go. This is why we are actually going to define 0 factorial to be equal to 1. Hopefully this right here, you know, gives you some idea of what the factorial is. It has a lot of applications, especially when you get to statistics and probability when you talk about combinatorics. And also later on in calculus, you will see the factorial happening in the what we call the sequence and series. But that will be for another day, or maybe you can check out my other video for them. Anyways, that's it.